वाहेगुरु जी का खालसा, वाहेगुरु जी की फतेह। आई वार्मली वेलकम टू एंटायर संगत इन आवर स्पेशल टॉक, इन आवर स्पेशल वीकली टॉक अबाउट अंडरस्टैंडिंग गुरबानी इन इंग्लिश। एंड आवर टॉपिक फॉर दिस वीक इज सिन एंड क्राइम पार्ट टू। प्रीवियसली वी डिस्कस्ड एंड ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड द डिफरेंस बिटवीन सिन एंड क्राइम। Normally, we believe both are same, but if we take a deep dive, it's huge difference and both are equal as well, because one thing is sin. The meaning of sin is thinking bad about someone. Whatever bad things we are just thinking, those comes under sin. If we are performing the same things by the help of our body, then those things comes under crime. So if we try to understand according to Gurbani is more focused on sin, because if we are thinking bad, then only we will do bad. Both are almost equally related as well. Or we can say the same energy is in our mind as well, in our body as well. If we are thinking something, that reflects on our body as well. If I am angry and if I am thinking about my bad experience, so then definitely the reaction of those experiences can be seen on our face as well. In another way, if we think someone takes liquor or someone drinks liquor by the body, but still there is a difference in mind as well. But normally if we say, then it's not related to mind. Drinking alcohol should just harm only body. But no, it reflects mind as well. In the same way, if we are angry, we are thinking something bad. So those things or expressions can be seen in our body as well. So now we will try to understand. We'll try to go a little ahead. Previously, we have already discussed what is sin, what is crime. Sin is thinking bad. Crime is performing bad with our body and any harassment if we are doing. So all things are coming under crime. So now what is the next process? If we want to get rid from our sins and crimes, so what we need to do? So for that, we will try to understand according to Gurbani. The first step and most important thing is self-realization and acceptance. Gurbani says, paap bura, paapi ko pyara, paap lade, पापे पासारा। पाप बुरा, sin is bad. In Gurbani, mostly we say the more focused is on sin. Or we can say every religion is more focused on sin and society is more focused on crime. So they don't want bad things in society, but religion don't want any bad or dirty thinking in our mind as well. Because the one who don't think, they'll never do it as well. So then in society, there are different kind of sins and many different kinds of crimes. So paap bura, sin is bad. Paap bura. Paapi kau pyara, the one who is doing it, sinner loves it. Although sin is bad, but sinner loves it. Why? Normally we may see or we can see one who like to kill people, a murderer or killer, they feel happy if they kill someone. A robber, if they got success in his robbery, they feel so happy. Even I read somewhere a big robbers who once if they can get huge amount in one robbery, they throw a party to other friends. They say like last time or this time, we got plenty of money. We got enough money. So we should have a party. So they like to throw the party to his friends if they got success in any crime. Paap bura, paapi ko pyara. Then the one who is doing ogi with someone, doing cheating with someone, they loves to do it. Killer loves to kill people. A murderer may loves his whatever he is doing. The one who is into the robbery, may he love to do robbery. So first thing we need to realize what we are doing, what kind of thoughts are coming into our mind. Paap bura, although sin is bad, paapi ko pyara, but paapi, the sinner, likes it. Paap lade paape paasara, and he just keep on increasing his sins and sins more and more. Entire time he is thinking about lust, thinking about greed, thinking about to give any harassment to someone, or any kind of any other things. So one is like this. But we need to look on ourselves. Eh man arsi koi gurmukh dekha. We need to look at our thoughts, what kind of thoughts are coming into our mind, which is very important. So first thing, we need to realize that sin is bad. Normally, we don't like it. We don't understand it. Normally, ki hunda hai? Paap, paapi nu changa lagda hai. Thaggi karna changa lagda hai. So, but once we started feeling like sin is like a burden, then only we can go ahead and we need to accept it. What? Paap kamavdeya tera koi na beli ram. No one is your friend while committing or while performing any kind of any sins or crimes. Most of the time, people commit the crimes and sins just to fulfill the wishes of his family. This is also true. Sometimes people make an excuse, I'm doing any kind of any yogi with someone, I'm cheating, I'm doing robbery or performing any crimes just because so that I can get enough money for food for my family. Kabir ji also discussed this thought as well. Boho par panch kar par tan lyave sut dara peh aan lutave man mere poole kapat na kije ant nebera tere ji pehli je. Boho par panch. Par panch means many different methods with many kind of things. Boho par panch kar, he's doing many things to get money, to earn some money. Par tanu lyave, par, not even his, someone else money. If what happens if a robbery, in the case of robbery, he's taking money, is par tan money. That tan, that money is par tan. That doesn't belong to that person, but still he steal it. Par tanu lyave. Sut dara. Sut means son. Dara means wife. Sut dara peh aan lutave. He steal money from someone else, but throw on his family. Then Kabirji says, man mere poole kapat na kiche. Never do these kind of things. Poolke, poole, not even by mistake. Do any kind of any cheating. Don't perform these kind of things. Why? Ant nebera tere ji pehli je. Because by the end of the time, you are the one who is responsible for his deeds. You are the one who is responsible for his sins. Whatever you are thinking, whatever you are performing, no one else is responsible for your deeds. You are the one who is responsible. Bhagat Kabir ji says it. And Guru Nanak Sahib ji also says the same thing. Aape bij, aape hi khao. Whatever you sow, the same, the shall you reap. Ditta laiye aapna, anditta kich hath na yaab. Bhai Gurdas ji also says the same thing. There is a story is also related to the same thing. Once upon a robber was there, a daku who used to kill people and take that money and other things from them and take to his house. His name was Daku Bali. So that was his passion, that was his work. So that was the thing he was performing for a long time. He just kill people, take their belongings and take to his house. What happened once he met with seven saints together, so which are known as Sapat Rishi. Sapat means seven. Rishi is like saints. So seven saints he met at one place, and this Daku, this robber, this killer felt so happy because he thought, today I got seven people together, so I can kill and I can get enough money from them. But sooner he realized they were not having enough money. They were not carrying any other things, any important, any good things or any costly or expensive things were not with them. All were so simple. So they were just wearing clothes. So he got so upset. Then Daku Bali told to those saints, he said, then Daku Bali said, I wanted to kill you so that I can get your money to my house. So then one of that saint replied, so we are sitting here, although we don't have much things, we are ready to give you, but why you are performing these kind of things? Daku Bali said, I'm doing all these things just for my family. Then saint replied and asked, the moment you will get punishment for your deeds, so will they spot you? Are you sure about it? Daku Bali said, yes, I'm sure about it. He said, we are here, just confirm with your family. Daku Bali asked to his family, if I get any punishment, if I ever get caught or some people will try to kill me or beat me, I'm sure my family will spot. Then his wife replied, I asked you for food. I did not tell you to kill people and get money. You can work. We did not say it. If people will catch you, if someone will kill you or beat you, we will not stand with you. You are the one who is performing, so you should be the one who should get punishment. We will not be with you. And the same kind of reply from his son as well. So this incident, it was the point of Daku Bali that changed his entire life. Then what happened? He asked for a company of those seven people. He said, I want to be with you. Please support me. Please guide me. Help me to walk on the path wherever you are walking. Definitely, I am on the wrong path. Because firstly, we need to realize. Once we realize we are on the wrong path, then only we can walk on the right path. Earlier, this Daku Bali used to think he's performing good deeds. He's just fulfilling wishes and desires and all things for his family. But later, he realized he's performing bad deeds. So firstly, realization is very much important. Then only we can go ahead. So what this Daku Bali did, he walked on the path of Almighty, and later he is the writer of greatest holy book of Hinduism named Ramayana. Daku Bali became Maharishi Valmiki, and few people or followers of Valmiki calls him Bhagwan Valmiki as well. So Bhagwan Valmiki, or other people says Maharishi Valmiki, because the writer of Ramayana, and earlier part he was Daku Bali. So life can be changed anytime, but firstly we need to realize we are performing, these are the bad deeds, or I'm committing crimes or sins. Once we will realize it, then what will happen? We will start putting efforts to go on the right path. Uddam karhe anek, har naam na gavahi. As of now, we are doing many things. Uddam karhe anek, we are diligence, we are performing many things, we are hard workers, karhe anek, in many ways. But har naam na gavahi, but we don't have time to remember God sometimes. We have enough time. I saw people who spend hours and hours in scrolling mobile phones, like scrolling social sites. They spend hours and hours. But if we say we can do at least Japji Sahib, it will take hardly 10 minutes. So they may say they are busy. But if even if we start looking on ourselves, so we are wasting a lot of time. Being busy is different thing. Being productive is different. Okay. Uddam kar hai anek. So we have a lot of time for other things. Har naam na gavahi, but don't have time to remember God. But once we realize what kind of things we are doing, what we are supposed to do, then we will put some efforts on the path of Almighty. Performing any kind of any seva in humanity, in Gurudwara, in any temple, helping someone is part of seva. It's part of walking on the path of Almighty. If we are performing Simran, we are spending some time to meditation, to remember God, to recite Gurbani, it is also part of effort. Even if we are not able to perform any seva or not getting enough time for Simran or reading Gurbani, reciting Gurbani, then even if we are coming to Satsang right now as we are discussing, and if we are trying to understand about Gurbani, what Guruji is saying us, so it is also a Satsang. On the virtual base, we are in the Satsang, we are giving our time to understand about good things. So this is also part, is like we are trying to walk. At least we are trying. It's, we are not discussing about the destination, because firstly, we need to try. The one who did not try, he can never reach. The someone who started trying, it may take some time, but he will reach for sure. So we can see many examples from the history as well as by Sajjanji. He was also a killer. He used to kill people. But the moment he met with Shri Guru Nanak Sahib Ji, Guru Nanak Sahib Ji just spoke one Shabad. Sajjan sei naal mein chal diyan naal chalan, jithe lekha mangiye, jithe khada disan. So Guru Sahib Ji just said one Shabad, and Pai Sajjan's life was completely changed. And we are, if we think about ourselves, we are listening many Shabads from long, long time, that we need to think about ourselves. Are we working on it, or we are just listening for listening? The real listening is performing, to taking those things into our life as well. Another example, Pai Malik Pago. He was also the same kind of person, but in the company of Shri Guru Nanak Sahib Ji, his life was changed. Pai Sundar Ji. Sundar was also a daku at the time of Maharaja Ranjit Singh Ji. At that time, he said, if someone is enough brave, who can win from me in any fight, I'll become his servant. So Maharaja Ranjit Singh had fight with him and he won it. So later, what Maharaja Ranjit Singh Ji did, he make him a general of his army. Like Hari Singh Nalwa was also a general, the same kind of Pai Sundar Ji was become. Earlier, he was also a daku. So he changed his energy into a good way. He did not kill him. He take him, or he just invited him to be a part of army. The same Pai Pidi Chand Ji, he was at the time of Sikh Guru, Shri Guru Har Gobind Sahib Ji. He was also a thief. But in the company of Gursikhs, his life was completely changed, and he's one of the very famous, or he was a well-known Gursikh, Pai Pidi Chand Ji. So when we will put efforts to walk on the path of Almighty, the moment sin and crime become a burden, we start feeling it's burden. Once we start feeling, I can't okay with someone, I can't cheat, I can't say anything bad, I can't be rude. Once we start feeling it, once sin becomes burden, then only we will put efforts into different things. This is a sure thing. Until unless we are enjoying our sins, So then we will not walk it. We need to think about it. Are we really enjoying our sins and crimes, or we really want to change it? Are we repeating the same sin again and again? Is it happening today? If I am angry and I thought from now onwards, I'll be never angry, I'll never say any harsh word to anyone. Are we repeating it again and again? Are we doing the same thing again and again? That we need to think about it. So once sin and crime becomes burden, then only we will put efforts to something else where we think like we can get some peace. Because committing all these sins, committing all these crimes, just we want some peace. We think like after committing a suicide or after getting enough money in the robbery, we may get happiness. So this is a final destination for us. But once we start walking on the path of Almighty, once we start walking or start struggling or start fighting with our heart, with our mind, as Guru Gobind Singh Ji also says, Khalsa so, jo kare nit jang. Who is the real Khalsa? The one who fights every day. So don't take in that way like we need to fight with every person physically. No. Khalsa so, jo kare nit jang. Nit means every day. But with whom we need to fight? We need to fight with ourselves. What happens in the morning once we wake up? We want to wake up and want to recite the name of Almighty, but our heart, our mind says, you can sleep for more time. It's not your age to go to Gurudwara. You have enough time. You can do it later. So this is the fight is every time is going inside. One way we are thinking we want to do good, but another way, another mind is saying, no, you can perform for such a longer time. That doing religious things, good things that you can do at the end of your age. Now it's the time to have or to spend in lust, greed and other things. So these kind of obstacles will come in our mind, in our heart whenever we will start walking on the path. But we must have trust on Guruji, Samrath Guru. Sirhat Tareo. He is Samrat. God is the one who can do everything, and we must feel it like Prabdori Hath Tumare. We must feel Prabdori Hath Tumare. My life is in your hand. However you say, I'm ready to walk in that way. So obstacles will come. Even these came in the life of Guru Nanak Sahib Ji. Koi kahe putna, ko kahe betala. People threw stones on Guru Nanak Sahib Ji. Guru Arjan Sahib Ji was set on Tatti Tavi. Guru Gobind Singh Maharaj, he lost his father, mother, all of his four sons. But still he said, Ae khuda aaj teri amanat ada hui, beton ki jaan kaum ki khatir fida hui. Still he said, I'm happy. I'm fine. Whatever God is doing, I'm all right. So whenever we are walking on the path, we may face some problems. People may criticize, but we have to make sure we are not doing these things to make people happy. We are performing so that God can be happy with our deeds. And even if we commit any suicide, any crimes, any sins, the moment we are ready to go back, Gurbani says, Jo sharani aave, whoever is ready to come, this kant laave. Kant means throat. It means like Guru will hug you. Ehe bird swami sanda. Bird means part of nature. It's God's nature. He will never say like you are a criminal, you are a sinner, there is no entry for you. No, God is always and always ready to accept us. We just need to walk it. Charan sharan gur ek penda jai chal, sat gur kot penda aage hoi let hai. Main murak ki ketak baat hai, kot paradhi taryare. Kot means crores, millions and millions. So main murak ki ketak baat hai. So even as we just try to understand and listen about the history, so there were people like Daku Bali or Ungli Mal or Pai Sajjanji, like Sajjan Thug became Pai Sajjan. So there are many examples. The moment they started to walk on the path of Almighty, Guruji accepts everyone. Guruji hugged everyone. Guruji is always ready. The moment is needed when we are ready to walk on the path. So because we are not ready yet, we are enjoying in sins and other things. So this is the problem. So we need to work on these things. So today's takeaways, our first thing is self-realization. If we want to come out of it, if we are ready, firstly, we need to realize it that sin is bad. If we are loving to gossip, it means still we did not realize. If we are feeling happy, if someone is getting some problems, so then there is a problem, still we did not realize it. So once we realize it, we will start feeling, once we start feeling like sin is a burden, so then only we can accept it ourselves. Yes, I have did many other things that I was not supposed to. Society is working on our crime, but Gurbani is working on our sins. If we will not think bad about someone, if once we accept it, then we will put efforts to walk on the path of Almighty, or we will start performing some good deeds that will help humanity to grow. But this is not as easy as well. We may face different kind of problems, different kind of things that may come. So different kind of barriers could be there, but we need to make sure our trust should be there on God. Then we will see a different kind of transformation within ourselves. Even if we see an example from daily life, the fire is within us, the same fire is in sun. The fire of stars is in our body. If we look at dust and if we look at our body, the same dust is transformation is our body. So how far this dust has become divine kind of things. Dust also became kind of divine. So this dust and body is same. Fire is same. Water of an ocean in our body is same. So every transformation is important and it's possible, but the basic thing is self-realization. We need to accept it that we are not on the right path. Then only once we accept it, then only we can put efforts. Once we start putting our efforts and be sure, don't lose your confidence. Then we do read in Pai Nandalal's Bani as well. Aage samaj chalo Nandalala, paache jo biti so biti. Whatever happened, that happened. We cannot change our past. But from now onwards, we may start thinking on our thoughts. We may start thinking on our deeds, what we are performing, why we are performing. Is it really good things? If any negative thought comes to our mind, we must start saying no to that thought. Like don't. We must work on our positive thoughts. That is why we join Satsangat. We come to Gurudwara. We perform Seva so that we can get some positivity in our life, so that will help us to go ahead. And Guru is always ready. Guru is always wants us to be with us. So this is what we need to work on it. So this is the transformation. This is possible. So I would request you all, and thank you so much everyone for giving your precious time and joining every week. And we all are trying to understand different concepts of Gurbani and how we can grow in our life. So now it's the time for all of you to interact with me. If you have any questions, if you have any doubts, if you have any feedbacks or wants to comment on something, or if you want to contribute, so that all feedbacks and all of your words are appreciated. So I would request you all may take a chance. And now I'll turn up the floor to Sangat so that you can share whatever you understand, or if you want to make more understanding for all of us. And before going ahead, I would just request you about two things. One is, Our another lecturer, you all would be aware about him, that Dr. Jaswinder Singh. He is leaving Singapore and going in another country. And for Thanksgiving program has been organized by Central Sikh Gurdwara Board's All Management Committee. It's on Saturday, 12th Feb in the morning, 10 a.m. to 11:30 a.m. at Silat Road Gurdwara Sahib. So request you all, whoever are listening or whoever are from Singapore. So request you all, if you are have time, so please come and join us in this program of Thanksgiving program. And the next day is on Sunday, we are celebrating Spring Chadeya Basant. So we'll try to understand, according to Gurbani, what is joyful spring and what Gurbani says us. We'll try to understand about these things in our coming days. So request you all may come. And thank you so much for your precious time and joining. Now I'm giving the option to unmute yourself. So whoever wants to contribute in his own way or on her own ways, so you all are most welcome. Thank you so much. Vahe Guru Ji Ka Khalsa, Vahe Guru Ji Ki Fateh Ji. Haan Ji, Harcharan Singh Ji, you are unmuted.
Vahe Khalsa Fateh Ji.
Vahe Guru Ji Ka Khalsa, Vahe Guru Ji Ki Fateh Ji.
I'm driving, but I'm going to participate in this as well.
Okay, sure.
I like that.
Okay, thank you.
Actually, the major thing is, I think, is manne ki gat kahi na jai. Mannana pehlo chahida. You have to believe that Guru Gobind Singh, Guru Nanak Dev Ji, our Guru Granth Sahib Ji is our true Guru. And we must submit to our Guru 100%.
Yes.
And only then can we achieve what we really want to achieve. The trouble is we don't surrender 100%. We surrender maybe 10%, 20%, maybe 30%, maybe 40%, maybe 50%, maybe 90%, 10% we still keep. And that is what creates a doubt in our mind and our body. Eh?
Yes, exactly, Chan Singh Ji. Welcome.
So, that's what we must do. That's the motto we must have. And Nandlal was so fortunate that he was at that particular time during Guru Gobind Singh's time. He was very, very fortunate. But I think we should not look at that, because even now we are fortunate because we have Guru Granth Sahib. That is what you have to believe, that Guru Granth Sahib is our living Guru. And whatever Guru Granth Sahib says, word for word, he's telling his Guru's teaching is really fantastic. You can get transformation if you really want to, and you must keep on and on and on. So, aage chalo nandala piche piche sab piche. That's it.
Vaheguru Ji ka Khalsa, Vaheguru Ji ki Fateh. Bilkul ji, thank you so much for sharing your views. Aage samaj chalo nandlala, pache jo biti, so biti. Guru is always ready to accept us. Thank you so much, Harcharan ji. Anyone else from Sangat who would like to contribute in her or his own way? Haan ji, Manjeet ji. Haan ji, anyone else? Haan ji, Gurmeet ji, would you like to add something?
Vaheguru Ji Ka Khalsa,
Vaheguru Ji Ki Fateh Ji.
Okay, I like the way you break down this, simplify the sin and crime definitions, and give us bite-sized ways of overcoming them, how to deal with them. And you quoted Bani verses and the many, you know, stories behind how people can change. I think all these kind of, you know, make us realize that end of the day is whether you want to or not, you know? So the option is always with you. And how do we get this? Because like our mind is always, you know, the five enemies that are in ourselves, they are always fighting. So to fight these enemies, the soldier that we need is actually Vaheguru.
Yes, you know? Exactly.
So he will be the one who will give us that strength to move forward, you know, and embolden us to say, no, this is not what I'm going to do. This is not what I'm going to think. Gusawi, I'm going to shudder. I'm going to spit out my gusa. I'm going to not get angry with this person. I'm not going to get jealous of this person. I'm not going. So all these are things that will make us want to go again and again back to the Bani as reference, as our, you know, like what I said, a body, a kind of a guide. Okay, a rasta neetik. We have to change. So yes, it is very, very, I think its baseline is Bani is our, I would say, light.
Yes.
Where, you know, at the end of the tunnel, because whatever it is, we head to that, we want that, make sure we work for it. And how? Every time remind our mind, nahi, any chaida karna, any sochna, any kama theek. You know, we keep on questioning our mind because our mind, you know, tend to go into getting angry, getting upset, getting, you know, like why that person has more than me, you know, jealousy exactly, and all those things. So these are things that will lead us to do the wrong thing. So from the sin that you're thinking, what you want to do, the wrong action becomes a action. And that is when you commit all kind of crimes. You get, make enemies. You hurt other people. Yes. You take things that don't belong to you, you know? So yes, the guilt kind of thing must be there to remind us that it's wrong. So exactly. I like the way you end off with Vaheguru's open arms to welcome us anytime, any part of our life when we want to change our thoughts to the right way and, you know, ask for salvation, you know? So Vaheguru is always there for us, forgiving us like a father will forgive his child, a mother exactly will forgive her child.
Exactly.
So I think Guruji will forgive us for whatever we may do wrong. But at the end of the day is, have we learned? Have we changed? That is what we must keep on telling ourselves.
Exactly.
So I think like your way of telling all the efforts, you know, self-realization, acceptance, effort, obstacle, trust, transformation. I think all this will happen only when we do take the first step. And that is to have a change in our life. And positivity is so important. Always, sab kuch jo honda theek wa is always in a good light. You don't even think about the bad side of it. Because when you start thinking of the bad, you will never change or you will never want to see better things or the other side. You say, no, a gal, you know, you can do, become overindulged in it. So get out of it, have a positive mindset, I'll move on. And I will go for the positive things in life too.
Oh,
so with that, Vaheguruji ka khalsa, Vaheguruji ki fateh
masa. Vaheguruji ka khalsa, Vaheguruji ki fateh gurmuji. Thank you so much for sharing your views and summarizing in your own way. So it's very nice and we like the way you express yourself. Thank you so much, Gurmuji. Anji, Anji, anyone else from Sangat who wants to contribute? Hanji Kartarji, you are unmuted.
Vaheguru Ji ka khalsa, Vaheguru Ji ki fateh master.
Vaheguru Ji ka khalsa, Vaheguru Ji ki fateh Kartarji.
Panji Gurmeet has well said, as she ended it, that Vaheguru's open arms are always there for us. Actually, he is there from the day we were born, we were made up.
Exactly.
When we were young, we were innocent and we were very pure. He was always there with us. But as we grow up, there are situations that make us change. And some things in life, we have our needs and wants, right? Sometimes to go up, we need to push somebody. Either we push him hard or we push him lightly. Sometimes we need to do it to progress and we need motivation to go forward. So we cannot consider that as greed. To progress, we need to push some people around just to reach to the top. Because no path is covered by roses. There are always thorns there.
Yes,
and we sometimes have to step on the thorns, have to step on the roses to reach our destination. So will that be considered as sinful, bad? No, I think that is achievement in our life, materialistic things. We want a house, we want a car, but how we get it?
Exactly.
Is it the right action? Is the right way? Or did we do, went into the wrong direction to achieve that success? That is very important. We need to understand that first.
Yes,
and
exactly.
Last, I consider last love. We love our parents. We love our husband. We love our children, our siblings. I don't consider that as lust. Unless I lust after something else, which does not belong to me, that will be lust. But to lust after our own husband or children or family, that we have to understand the difference between the two words, how we take it into our mind. If we can differentiate and understand that, then I think we can also get over the obstacles, trust in Guru that he's showing us the right path, follow his teaching, and not transform. I think we should know ourselves what we are doing. And you explained your short stories for self-realization, your seva. They were excellent because these small stories actually tell us how to overcome or how to achieve these actions, right?
Exactly.
To get over these things, how to realize ourselves. Because just by reading the Bani, sometimes we don't understand. But with the short stories or examples that you give, make us understand the whole Shabad more clearly. For that, I must really thank you very much. As for the end of the day, it is just you yourself and your mindset.
Exactly.
You yourself, you know what you want, in what way you want to achieve, and what direction you want to take. If you can understand that and follow God's teaching, I think you will reach your destination safely. And God is always there with you. Thank you very much, Masterji. It was a very well explained lesson today. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Kartarji. You really explained and summarized very beautifully. I was just loving to hear you. I was saying like you may say for a few more minutes as well. So
Thank you very much, Masterji. Vaheguruji ka khalsa.
Vaheguruji ki fateh, Kartarji. Thank you. Anji, Anji. Anyone else from Sangat who wants to share his views or feedbacks? So you all feedbacks are most appreciated. So please take a time. Hanji. Hanji Hardeep ji.
Vaheguruji ka khalsa, Vaheguruji ki fateh.
Vaheguruji ka khalsa, Vaheguruji ki fateh, Hardeep ji.
Yes, Satvinder, it's a very good lecture. You have itemized all these takeaways and explained very well with all the stories about how criminals have changed, with sometimes with a bani, sometimes with things that they realized,
yes,
and they changed. So there is hope and scope to change.
Yes.
And bani which we likhya, jai khima te aap. So forgiveness is there. Vaheguru will forgive. And we need to work on it. If we commit any kind of sin or crime, it is we who need to work on it. And as you say, sometimes we have to fight with ourselves, you said earlier. So it's all in our mind and how we can change. So God is always with us. We need to change and be positive. And as you said, say no to bad thoughts. So I learned a lot from today's lesson. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. Very beautifully. And in few words, you really summarized it very well. Thank you so much, Hardeep ji. Hanji, anyone else from Sangat who wants to contribute? Hanji, Sharanjit ji, Diljit ji, Amarjit ji, Balbir ji. Okay, next week again, we will come with a new topic. And now I request you all may unmute yourself and we all can say Vaheguruji's Fateh together, all together. So request you all, please unmute all of you. So let's say together, Vaheguruji ka khalsa, Vaheguruji ki fateh. Thank you so much, everyone. Thank you, everyone. Thank you.